So here we have the BMW 118i Sport Automatic on an 18 plate. I'm going to start off by showing you around the outside of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But from the outside, you can see it's a five-door car with alloy wheels. Let's start off inside the boot and then work our way around the rest of the car from there. So as we approach the boot, you'll see we have plenty of boot space along with that 60-40 split folding rear seat. Okay, so we're just going to work our way back round to the front of the car now, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But now that we've done a full circle of the car, you can see it's in wonderful condition the whole way round. Just briefly before I climb in, I think it's worth seeing the interior from this exterior point of view. The seats are as good as new. There's plenty to run through on the dashboard, so let's hop in and we'll do that right now. Okay, so now they're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. On the right hand side we have the rev counter, and on the left hand side the speedometer and fuel gauge. At the bottom in the middle you can see the total miles on this car are 6,135. You can change the information displayed above that by pressing a button on the end of the indicator stalk. You can have a digital readout for the speedometer, as you can see there, otherwise it's various different bits of fuel economy information. If we back out to the steering wheel, on the left hand side we have a speed limiter, and on the right hand side we have stereo controls and the ability to answer phone calls and use the voice activation. So if you hit that button, you could for example ask it to dial anyone in your contacts list, and it can do that for you without you having to take your phone from your bag or pocket. That is of course once you've paired up your phone, and that is done on the central screen just here under the communication heading there. Now you can see, obviously I'm moving through the menus at the moment, all of that movement is done using BMW's iDrive system, which is essentially this dial. You can turn it, you can push it down, you can move it to the right, left, up or down as well, so like this, and it will take you through various menus as you do that. So for example, when it comes to music, the media and radio heading, push the button down. You can see there radio wise we have DAB, FM and AM radio. We have a CD player. We can pair up our phone for Bluetooth audio, and we have USB input as well. So plenty of ways to listen to music. On top of all of that, you can use the satellite navigation in the car. So there's a full video showing exactly how the satellite navigation works on both our website and our Facebook page, which are both well worth checking out. Beneath that, we have the CD player, followed by the climate control. So you can adjust the fan speed up and down from here. Temperature, hot and round to cold, and you can see that'd be 22 degrees, 24 degrees, you know, somewhere in the middle at kind of 19, 21. And you can adjust that to wherever you like it. You can determine where you'd like the air to be distributed. Then hit that button to turn the air conditioning on. It's as simple as that. Or you can hit auto. The car will now maintain the temperature you've asked for by taking control of the fan speed itself. You can override that by simply pressing the auto button again to turn it off. Below that, we have a couple of cup holders and a 12-volt charging socket underneath that cap, so if you can charge your phone, for example. The fully automatic gearbox. And then finally, to the right-hand side of that, we have these buttons here. These will enable us to change the driving setup of the car. So you can put the car in sport mode, for example, or you could put it in Eco Pro. And in any case, it changes the firmness of the steering, it changes how the accelerator pedal will react, and how the car will change gear. Whatever setting you put it in, you will be told that you're in that setting up on the main screen. You can also, down here, turn off traction control should you wish to, using that button there. All that leads me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.